ordered, will order during the day, probably right after the funeral, a state court of inquiry headed by the Attorney General, which he will have associated with him, one or two of the outstanding civil liberties juries in the country. Perhaps Jaworski represented the Attorney General in the Fifth Circuit Negro case, or in head of the Trial Lawyers of America, or Dean Story, or...
somebody from outside Texas. Somebody from outside Texas.
They're going to have the FBI from outside Texas, but this is under Texas law, and they take all the involvements, and we don't send in a bunch of carpetbaggers. It's the worst thing you could do right now.
You think so?
I know. Well, we got the FBI doing anything that, if there's any question about Texas operation, they got an FBI that's going to the bottom of it and direct with the Attorney General. But paralleling that is a Blue Ribbon State Court of Inquiry headed by the President Attorney General and associated with him somebody like St. John Garwood, Will Clayton's son-in-law, who was a brilliant Supreme Court justice that's retired, somebody like Roberts did in Pearl Harbor. And that's what the Attorney General's doing. Now, if we have another commission, hell, you're going to have people running over each other, and everybody agrees. Now, I know that some of the lawyers, they thought of the Blue Ribbon Commission first, the justice. And we just can't have them lobbying against the president when he makes these decisions. We decided that best thing to counterattack, number one, to put an FBI in full force, number two, to put the state in full force. Now,
Nobody lobbied me. I lay awake all night.
Oh, that's you. They lobbied me last night.
Did they?
Yeah, I spent the day on it. I had to leave Ms. Kennedy's side at the White House and call and ask the Secret Service and FBI to proceed immediately. I spent most of my day on this thing yesterday. I had the Attorney General Pictures fly in here. I spent an hour and a half with him yesterday evening. I talked to the Justice Department lawyers and to the FBI. The FBI is of the opinion that the wisest, quickest, ablest, most effective way to go about it is for them to thoroughly study it and bring in a written report to the Attorney General at the earliest possible date, which they've been working on since 12:30 yesterday, number one. And they have information that's available to no one that has not been presented thus far and so forth. Number two, to parallel that, we're having a Blue Ribbon Court of Inquiry.
In Texas.
In Texas. Where this thing occurred.
Mr. President, just let me give you my political judgment on the thing. I think you've done everything that could probably be done.
We just don't want to be in a position, I'll make this one statement and I'm through. I want to hear you. We don't want to be in a position of saying that we have come in to a state other than the FBI that they pretty well accept, with some outsiders and have told them that their integrity is no good and that we're going to have some carpetbag trials. We can't haul off people in New York and try them in Jackson, Mississippi. We can't haul off people in Dallas and try them in New York.
I see that, Mr. President. But
they're constitutional. Right, go ahead now.
Just let me make one suggestion, because I think this covers, I think this bridges the gap, which I believe, and Dean Acheson believes, still exists. Dean and Bill Moyers are the only people I've talked to about it. And Friendly is going to come out tomorrow morning with a big thing about a Blue Ribbon Commission, which he thought of independently. It isn't just the Department lawyers who are carrying on this. It's just things happen to thought of a lot of people, and you've thought of more of the details than anyone else. And I'm sure you're right, except there's one missing piece. I suggest that you announce that as you do not want the Attorney General to have the painful responsibility of reporting on his own brother's assassination, that you have authorized three jurists, and I would suggest a Texas jurist and two non-Texas jurists, to review all the evidence by the FBI and produce a report to the nation for the nation. And after the investigation is completed, so that the country will have the story judicially reviewed outside Texas. And if you tell Bill Moyers to call up Friendly, and if you get out such an announcement this afternoon, you're going to make a marvel. Well, you've already made a marvelous start. You haven't put a damn foot one quarter of an inch wrong. And I've never seen anything like it. You've been simply marvelous in the most painful circumstances. But I do feel that there is that much of a gap. And I'm sure that if Moyers calls friendly, you'll have a terrific support from the Washington Post and from the whole of the rest of the press instantly.
I'll learn both procedures we've got, though.
No, you won't. No, you won't. Just use the procedures you've got and add to those procedures a statement saying that when the FBI has completed its work, when it has completed its work, as you do not wish to inflict on the Attorney General the painful task of reviewing the evidence concerning his own brother's assassination, you have asked two or three, including, I would include, the best judge on the Texas bench, American jurists beyond, or individuals, Dean Acheson, for example, two or three individuals beyond any possible suspicion as to their independence and impartiality, to draw up a written report giving to the public everything of the FBI evidence that is relevant. And then you will have this written report, which is not Texas, which tells the whole story, which is based on the FBI evidence, which doesn't need to use the things that the FBI says can't be used, and yet will carry absolute conviction and will just be that little extra added to the admirable machinery you've already got that will carry complete conviction.
My lawyers, Joe, tell me that the White House must not inject himself into local killings.
I agree with that, but in this case, it does happen to be the killing of the president.
Right.
And the thing is, I'm not suggesting... Mind you, Mr. President, I'm not talking about an investigative body. I'm talking about a body which will take all the evidence that the FBI has amassed when they have completed their inquiry and produce a public report on the death of the president. That, I think, you see, that is not an interference in Texas.
No, but it's...
Wait a second now. That is a way to transmit to the public without breach of confidence and in a way that will carry absolute conviction what the FBI has turned up.
Why can't the FBI transmit it?
Because no one, again, on the left, they won't believe the FBI. And the FBI doesn't write very well.
They make Katzenbach?
I just wouldn't put it on Bobby and Nick Katzenbach. I'd have it outside. I think it's unfair to put it on Bobby. It's unfair to put it on Bobby. This very small addition of the admirable machinery that you've already set up will help you, and I believe that it will strike the imagination of the country and be a very useful, happy thing. I see all the arguments you make, and you're dead right, and my perception is completely wrong, but I do think that additional feature is needed.
I talked to, after midnight last night with the...
Well, I know how you must have been concerned.
The truly civil liberties lawyer in this town, in my judgment, the man has made the best arguments before the Supreme Court, and it was his judgment, the worst mistake we could make.
I now see exactly how right you are and how wrong you are about this idea of a blue ribbon commission.
Now, you see, Katzenbach suggested that. And I provoked it. The lawyers at the council and me just hit the ceiling, said, God Almighty.
I see that you're right and that he was wrong. I don't know anything about Katzenbach because I haven't talked to him for 3 weeks, what I am suggesting is not at all what Katzenbach suggested. I'm suggesting simply a device.
Let me talk to Acheson.
For summing up the result of the FBI inquiry in a way that will be completely coherent, detailed, and will carry unchallengeable conviction. And this carrying conviction is just as important as carrying on the investigation in the right way. And I worry about this post-editorial. I'd like you to get ahead of
them. Well, I worry about post, period.
Well, I do too. I'd like you to get ahead of them. And if you have, if you make this decision and have Moyers call friendly or Kay, instead of being, well, you know, this is what we ought to do, this is what ought to be done, and then what you do being denounced as inadequate, they'll be flattered and will do you a tremendous piece. And I'm sure that you will have the strongest possible support. It'll be thought that everything has been done that needs doing. But I do think, my own judgment is that there is that little missing piece. And Dean may disagree, and you talk to him.
I'll talk to him, and...
And I hate to interfere, sir. I only dare to do so because I care so much about you.
Know that, Joe.
And I have the deepest faith in you, and I think you've been right and I've been wrong as to the general conception.
What a question. It's not really my thinking. I'm not enough experienced.
I'm really... What I'm really honestly giving you is public relations advice, not legal advice.
Well, I've not found it. I don't have the depth of the civil liberties picture that some of the folks that have worked on this with me. I had a lawyer left my house last night after midnight and spent, I guess, 3 or 4 hours going over this thing from A to Z after the Attorney General. It was called in here yesterday afternoon after the FBI was put on it, after we told Secret Service to make available everything they had. And we thought that this was the best way to handle it.
Yeah, well, I repeat, I must not keep you because you'll be late getting into your trousers, but I repeat, I think your decisions have been 200% right. And I was wrong. But from a public relations standpoint, from the standpoint of carrying conviction, there is that missing piece which is easy to supply without infringing upon Texas feelings or sovereignty.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you, sir. Goodbye.